There are two types of O2 sensors, the narrow band and the wide band. This sensor is a narrow band, zirconia type, which is the most common narrow band sensor used.
If there's more than two wires, then it has an inside heater. This has three wires. In general, the two same color wires are for the heater. Here is the white ones are for the heater, and the black is for the signal. Also receiving ground from the metal body. Now testing the O2 sensor heater circuit if it's receiving power from the connector. It's better to perform this test when the exhaust system is cold. Some O2 sensor's heater circuit will turn off when the exhaust pipes are hot enough. These are the wires matching the O2 sensor two white wires. Multimeter on 20 volts DC. Starting the engine and checking the connector. And if it has four wires like this one, two wires are for the heater, and two wires are for the signal. Here the two white wires are for the heater, and the black and gray wires are for the signal. To test the O2 sensor with a multimeter, first you should check its specification. Here is the O2 sensor specification for this car. This test is for the O2 sensor that's located before the catalytic converter. So here the heater resistance should be approximately 9 ohms at 20 degrees Celsius, that's 68 Fahrenheit. Multimeter on 200 ohms. Here the white wires. Also between the heater wires and the signal wires shouldn't be any reading. Now checking the O2 sensor signal and response time with the multimeter. This won't be accurate. You should use an oscilloscope, but it will give you an idea. O2 sensor's response cycles between lean and rich, and rich and lean vary between sensors. You should check the specifications, but for this car it's about 2 times in a second 0.2. That's what it should look like on an oscilloscope. First, warm up the engine. The O2 sensor won't operate correctly until the engine reaches its operating temperature. Then set the multimeter on 2 volts DC. Connect the leads to the black and gray wires. Then increase the RPM to 2000. A good O2 sensor will show a rapidly fluctuating voltage between 0.1 and 1 volt. If the sensor output voltage is constant about 0.45 volts, or its response is too slow, it should be replaced. And if the sensor output voltage reaches higher than 0.55 volts all the time, this indicates a rich mixture, and could be caused by one or more of the following. And if it's below 0.35 volts all the time, this indicates a lean mixture, and could be caused by one or more of the following. OBD2 scanner is reading better the voltage fluctuating. That's what it should look like on the scanner, fluctuating rapidly, but on oscilloscope is clearer. Generally above 90,000 miles, or 140,000 kilometers, O2 sensors will not work properly and should be replaced.